Hi everyone, welcome back to business studies class. In last class we have seen about sole proprietorship business. There we have studied the features, merits and demerits of sole proprietorship business, isn't it? There we have seen a business which is owned and managed by a person, a single person, sole owner. We call such type of businesses as a particular form of business, that is sole proprietorship business. So we have learned what all the advantages you have if you alone of owner of a business, isn't it? Along with merit, we have seen some of the demerits. If you are a single person to handle, to control, to manage your business, your investment will be very small. You cannot continue the business for long period because someone, like for example, a father starts a business, he is a single owner. If something happens to him, the son may or may not be interested. Any of the family members may or may not be interested to run the business. So at such point, what happens? The business has to be closed, isn't it? So such demerits we have seen, and even we have one of the major demerit, that is unlimited liability. When he earns profit, he enjoys everything. When it comes to the matter of loss, he is a single person who has to bear all the loss. In order to repay the loss, if his company assets are not, if business assets are not sufficient, he has to sell his personal assets in order to repay the debts what he has taken for the purpose of investing into the business. So that is what the greatest demerit of sole proprietorship business we say, that is unlimited liability, isn't it? So such unlimited liability has given a scope for another form of business organization, that is what you are partnership. As the name, as the term we understand, partnership in the sense we want to start something, we want to do something not alone, but we want someone who have same ideology, who can work as us, who can work with us. Is that clear? So the demerits of sole proprietorship business has given rise for another form of business organization, that is another type of ownership for a business. That is, till now we have learned you can be a single owner for business, but in this concept called partnership, we'll be learning that we can have more than one owner for a particular business. It is as simple as it says. Partnership in the sense, you will be asking or you will be taking someone who can work with us by contributing capital, by taking risk and also by sharing the profits. So try to understand, we have seen there is no law governing our sole proprietorship business, but we have a law governing our partnership, that is Partnership Act of 1932 we see. So partnership is a form of business organization where you don't find single owner, you will be finding people together working for achieving a particular purpose. Now you are not a single owner of business, we have two or more than two. Is it clear? So partnership is a form of business where the people who have mutual understanding, the people who have common idea, come together to start a single business. Now all will be responsible. For example, I alone cannot do because my capital will be limited. By taking all the profits, I will be happy. But when it comes to the matter of losses, I alone has to bear everything. No, I need someone with whom I can share my risk, loss. So in such a situation, even I cannot give entire investment to my business. So I'll take someone who can invest along with me into my business. Now both A and B are the partners. Is it clear? So in this concept, we'll understand what are the features and merits and demerits. So we have understood the sole proprietorship business features, merits and demerits. In a similar way, we are going to study the concept of partnership. Here we have characteristics, that is what the features. As I say, when you understand the features, that is characteristics of a particular concept, you will be understanding its nature, how it is, how it acts, you will be able to understand. We'll see the features, that is the characteristics of partnership form of business organization. You should able to know all these things because when you want to start a business, you have to know which form of organization you want to have. That is, which type of ownership you want to have for your business. Now we have seen sole proprietary. Now we are going to see partnership. You compare both and then you select a right form of business organization for yourself, for your business. Let us start with the features. Two or more members, you can see. See, the number of members, for a sole proprietorship is one. We know that he is a single owner. But for our partnership, it is two. Minimum is two. Okay. Number of members, that is what two or more members has been given. So, your partnership, when you want to start a partnership business, minimum two members you should have. One yourself and one more you have to take. One more person who is having a mutual understanding, who is having same ideologies to start such a business, who is interested to share profit, who is interested to even share the loss, and who is invested to contribute capital. So you have to find such person and you have to make partnership with him. You have to say okay to start a business. So we say minimum is two members for any partnership. You want to have a form of organizationship, your ownership should be a partnership form, then minimum you should have two members. Then what about maximum? How many members you can have? As per Companies Act of 2013, it is 100. As you understand, as per companies, we have some other act called Companies Act of 2013. Okay, so as per that act, it defines how many members should be there as a members, okay, in the partnership firm. So it says 100, but as per Miscellaneous Companies Act, it is reduced to 50. Is it clear? So maximum how many partners can be there, how many owners can be there for a partnership firm is, as per Companies Act of 2013, it is 100, but as per your Miscellaneous Act, we have only 50. So you can say maximum is 50, minimum is 2. This you have to remember. So this is quite opposite to your sole proprietor. Sole proprietor, we should have single person as a owner, but here we say minimum 2 owners can be there, or it can be extended up to 50. As per Miscellaneous Act, if you go with the textbook, you can find that as per Companies Act of 2013, it can be extended up to 100. This you have to remember. Then comes another feature called agreement. Your partnership form, when people come together, minimum 2 and maximum 50, or it can be 100. Okay. So when they come together, they have to write an agreement. Agreement, it is a mutual consent of people written on a paper duly signed and stamped by all the partners. Because now I say one thing, but later I can deny what I said. I may say, no, I didn't say that. So it is better to have a written agreement. Is that clear? So a partnership firm can be started with a written agreement. That is what we say, formation. Similar to your sole proprietorship, even partnership firm, we don't have compulsory registration. Though we have an act governing Partnership Act, that is Partnership Act of 1932 in India, there is no compulsion for the partnership firms to be registered under government. It can or it may not be registered. It can function without registration. Okay. But if at all it is not registered also, an agreement is very important between the partners who are willing to start a firm. So this agreement we call it as partnership deed. Did you get it? It is a partnership deed. It is a written agreement between the partners. It can be 2 or it can be maximum to 100, or as per Miscellaneous Act, it can be of 50. Okay, so they have to give their consent in writing of what investment they are making into the partnership firm, what is the percentage of their profit, what they want to share, what is the percentage of loss, what they want to take, what are their responsibilities, what are their rights. Everything will be mentioned in that agreement. By signing and by having a stamp over that particular agreement, we can start our partnership firm. See, for sole proprietorship, it can be started without any legal formalities, isn't it? But to start a partnership firm, there should be an agreement, that is a written consent between the partners, which is duly signed by everyone. So that acts as a proof for their agreement, their consent to start a partnership firm. And next, it can be a lawful business. So as we say, it is a lawful business if you, it is seen one of the lawful form of business organization because it can be registered under Partnership Act of 1932. So when you register under Partnership Act of 1932, it will be considered as a lawful business and you will be having so many benefits from the government. That what all those things we'll be seeing in later classes under heading registration of partnership firm. Okay, then comes sharing of profit and loss. So when you have partners, everyone will be having their ratio of sharing profit and also loss depending upon their contribution. You might studied partnership accounts in your accountancy subjects. There you might see in the partnership account. So you might be knowing what is the share of his investment, what is the share of his profit, what is the share in his bearing the loss, everything you might see in there. That is what you are sharing of profit and loss. In case of sole proprietorship, you don't have any share in profit or loss. Everything he has to bear. Okay, if he enjoys, when he want to have all the profits, but he suffers when he has to bear all the loss. But in partnership, what happens? Both profit and loss can be shared. Then comes unlimited liability. The same feature what we have seen in the sole proprietorship business, but the only difference is there the unlimited liability is only a feature of single person. He is a single person who has to sell his personal property in order to repay the debts of company business. But here you will be having more than one. If you have 5 partners into your business, 5 has invested, 5 will share the profit, 5 will share the loss. Similarly, when firm is in loss, if it is a partnership firm, you have to say as firm, okay, business, okay. When there is a loss, all the 5 has to sell their personal property according to the ratios and they have to bring the money and they have to pay to the company loss. Now, it is not the single person who is selling his personal asset, it is all the partners who are in the partnership firm and signed in an agreement has to sell their personal property accordingly, according to the debts what they have taken, according to the money what they have borrowed, and they have to repay to the people. Is it clear? So here risk is shared. Then comes, it is a voluntary registration. Voluntary registration. As I said, you don't have any compulsion to register your firm. You may function without registration, but the only thing is if you register under the government, you will be enjoying some benefits from the government. So it is a voluntary registration. No one compel you. The Indian government will not compel all the partnership firms to take register, that is to undergo the registration. No, just as a sole proprietorship business, even your partnership firms can be commenced and can be function without registration. That is what voluntary registration means. If you are willing, if you want to take, if you want to avail the benefits of government, you can register. If not, you can function without registration. You don't have compulsion. That is what voluntary registration. If you are willing, you can register. If you are not willing, you can function like that. Then comes principal agent relationship. This is what we say mutual agency. Mutual agency. See, agent is the one who binds other. Principal is the one who will be bound by others. For example, A and B are there. A and B, 2 partners are there. Okay. So, when A says that we'll do this, we have to do this, B agrees for that. Okay, in that case, A becomes agent, B becomes principal. It is not principal, it is principal. You have to remember. Okay, when A says, we'll do this, okay, so B have to agree for that. Generally, B will agree that. So, A is an agent here and B is a principal. When B says, we'll do this, A has to agree for that. So, in this case, B is a principal, A is an agent. B is an agent and A is a principal. So agent is the one who binds others. Principal is the one who will be bound by others. In your partnership, all will be binding others and all will be bound by others. Is it clear? See, for example, we have 5 members as a partners A, B, C, D, E, all the five are there. When A says something as per the agreement, all the four, that is B, C, D, E, agrees for that. That is, A is an agent. He is binding the four with his decision. Clear? See, if some A does some wrong thing, he has done some mistake which made this partnership firm to go under loss. A has taken some decision, okay, which made partnership firm to undergo loss. So in this case, B, C, D, E are also bound to bear the loss. So A is an agent, all the four has become principal. They are bound by A. Is that clear? Similarly, now B has done some good thing. He has done good, taken a right decision, and it resulted in making firm into profits. Firm has made profit. Now the A, C, D, E, all are getting the profit because of the good decision, right decision, intelligent decision of B. So now B becomes agent. That is, B is binding everyone and all other are bound. So all other are considered as principal. So now A has, when he has done a mistake, he has bound others, then he was an agent. Now when B has become an agent, A has become the principal. It means in partnership, all becomes agent and all becomes principal. When he is binding other, he is an agent. When he is bound by others, he is an principal. Hence, we say partnership is a type of a business which is run by everyone, or it can be anyone acting for all. So, on behalf of everyone, A is acting. On behalf of everyone, A is acting. For example, B, C, D, E, all has contributed. They will take the profit, they'll bear the risk. But they are not actually into the business. They don't want to take any risk into the business. Just they contribute capital, they bear the loss. If they get profit, they enjoy the profit. But directly, they don't want to involve in day-to-day affairs of the business. It is only the A which is taking the active part into the business. But whenever profit comes, all the five will contribute share the profit. When there is a loss, all the five has to bear the loss. Are you getting me? So there is A, he's a single person who is acting for all. Or it can be another way, all the five will be acting for all. Any one acting for all or everyone acting for everyone. It is like that. That is what we say, mutual agency. Every partner becomes agent and every partner becomes principal. When you are binding other partners through your act, we call him as an agent. When you are bound by some other partner through his acts, you are called a principal. That is what mutual agency, which is a special feature of your partnership firm. The next, continuity of business. We have seen the continuity of business as a demerit for your sole proprietor. If something happens to the sole proprietor, the business may or may not continue because no one might be having interest in running such a business. They may not show interest, so they may just quit the business. They can just close the business, and it is so easy to close also. You don't have much legal formalities. All right. The same demerit, such a feature we have for partnership firm. See what happens. Initially, some five partners come together, five members as a partners come together to start a partnership firm. And suddenly, in the middle, before the time completes, we have agreed to be partners for a particular business for 5 years. Five members for 5 years. But unfortunately, to someone, something happened. He is unable to be a partner. We just take, one has expired. Okay. Then what happens? Other four, they want to continue the business, but they have to cancel that agreement. They want to remove the partner who has expired, and they want to have a new partnership deed, that is new agreement, change of ratios and all, investment change, sharing the loss, there is a change, share of profit, there is a change, and then it should be signed by all the four, stamped, and it can be functioned as it is. Are you clear? So the business can be continued, but what happens? The agreement has to be cancelled. Because of the illness, because of some other things, if anything happens to a particular partner, the business can continue, but the agreement dissolves. Means the agreement fails, you have to close that agreement and you have to make a new deed and then you can continue. Such a issue we have with the partnership firm. But in case of sole proprietor, the business may close. But in partnership firm, in sole proprietor, the business may close. But in partnership firm, there may not be such a situation to close or dissolve the partnership firm, but it will be, you might say, in dissolution of partnership also in your accounts. That is what closing, winding up of your partnership firm. So literally they may not close the business, but in the books of accounts it has to be closed. Means you have to close all the accounts and now you have to make a new deed and new accounts has to be, book has to be started for your partnership. The name may continue like that. The terms and conditions will change because one partner, before you were 5, now you will be only 4. Okay, so everything changes. The investment changes, the ratio of profit changes, the ratio of sharing the risk loss changes, everything changes. Hence what happens, we also study a feature called lack of continuity in partnership. But literally you don't stop doing the business, but the agreement in the books of accounts will be closed and now you have to start with the new agreement. So these are the features of partnership firm. Okay, you should go with the notes and then compare the explanation with the notes, you will understand in a better way. And if you have any doubts, you can just feel free to call me. Till we meet in our next class, take care. Bye-bye.